the largest Monster Jam event in the world.
Here we go. Oh my gosh, that was huge.
The things that you don't think are physically possible happen there.
The monster truck was just in orbit.
You had the most awesome competition you've ever seen in your life. You're locked in that moment, and it's all or nothing.
Off the container ramp, yes!
You get your 2 minutes in freestyle to put on the best run, and everybody is gunning for that championship.
I want to win that championship.
I want to win against the best.
I just want to win another one.
You come out on top.
That's what World Final is about.
Unfortunately, wasn't able to fill the full time though.
Oh yeah,
don't think so.
Scores are up on the board, and there you see it, a split between the judges and the fans. Pretty even. It all culminates with a 5.785, and there is your score to beat.
We've got Zombie Driver, Bari Moosauer, and Bari this entire weekend. The weather has had a mind of its own. The track has had a mind of its own. I know you're going a little bit later in the freestyle lineup. Are you up here watching how the track is behaving?
Yeah, I just wanted to get a game plan. I wanted to see, you know, they cut these ramps out here for racing, so I just wanted to make sure that I had everything in my mind that I wanted to do. So I had to come out here and watch all these peers go, all these fierce competitors out here, because we are about to turn Nashville into Smashville tonight.
That's what we'd like to hear. I gotta ask you, because fans are loving the action. I gotta ask you, I know that when you enter the freestyle competition, you want to at least get those 30 seconds under your belt so that you qualify for a score. But we are at Monster Jam World Finals. There's no such thing as playing it safe. There's no such thing as being conservative. So talk to us about how you're going to approach the competition.
You really just have to go for it and let it all hang out. You got to get a little bit lucky. You got to have some skill. You got to have that wow factor. You guys want to see a backflip tonight?
Was running one arm. Talk
to us
about why you did that.
Well, we run the pro tree here at Monster Jam World Finals, and that zombie arm kind of gets in my line of sight when I go up there to stage. So the left lane is okay, but the right lane, that arm gets in my way. So we took it off for racing, but it's back. We got both zombie arms for freestyle, and I want to see everybody here in Nissan Stadium doing zombie arms. Let's come out.
Let's see the score 12.583. Score for Monstermon is... We are joined by one of our expert judges and the man from the Thunder Roars Drop 9 Truck Show, Colton Engelberger. Colton, you and I have been talking all day long, but now the stuff is in the rearview mirror. You pulled it off. How you feeling?
Feeling pretty good. I told you guys we put a lot of time into that Monster Jam set. That was one of the wild moments. It's just gonna start and tease you for this Monster Jam freestyle. We have a feeling it's gonna get a little more great.
Thank you. that you would want it at a back limit. Unspoken, a lot of air. Well done to Cody Jones today. Because the judges are very critical. These expert judges are judging you on, are you fast, are you going big, and are you filling your time?
And right on cue, there's the score to beat Monster Rod, 7.167. Let's see if everybody agrees with Morgan Kane. The score for Dragon is... 7.795.
Thank you.
Chris Caller has been hanging on for a moment, 7.978. The score for Shaker is... he will land in third place, 6.822. Almost identical numbers from our judges and our fans. Either way, third place, score to beat still with Monster Mutt.
What an amazing run we just had right here in Monster Jam Freestyle. I am here with...
Corey Ballinger. Galena, Illinois!
Awesome, and who are you? Tommy Hunter, fucking Troy! I am loving that energy. Now, Monster Jam fans, right now we are going to do a best. This is Monster Jam competition. Now, these two competitors will give me their best. This is Monster Jam chant, and you, the Monster Jam fans in the stands, will help choose the winner because they are competing for a son of a nigger, Losi RC truck, brought to you by Horizon Hobby. We also have an additional competitor right here. He just came back in the bathroom. I hope you washed your hands. What's your name and where are you from?
Raul from Texas.
Raul from Texas. We're going to start off with you. Corey, go for it, Corey.
Hey, everybody, I'm Sergeant Bellinger in the United States Marine Corps. Let me hear a big oorah. This is the third jam!
All right. Raul, go for it.
Nashville and audience from all the world, this is Monster Jam. Let me hear some noise!
That was okay.
Last but not least, go for it, Tommy.
Nashville, look at all your things. Let me hear you. This is Monster Jam!
I'm going to be fair right now and let you Monster Jam fans out there decide. So, make some noise if you think Corey is your winner.
Come on, man.
Make some noise if you think Raul is your winner. Last but not least, make some noise if you think Tommy is your winner. It is the start of a nigga truck. Monster Jam fans, drop it up for Tommy. And let's get back to more Monster Jam Freestyle.
Coming up next here in the Freestyle World Championships, we're going to get a look at John LaDuke, Madonna.
And for someone that's been practicing that off the track, this is something that he put it to the test. I thought it was going to rotate. He did a great job turning a rear steer in the air. It was huge. The only thing I've seen in this run that I didn't see in the time is
the grounds in your electrical system are exactly where they need to be, because overgrounding them is a great thing. But you can see the frustration from Bryce Kenny in the truck. All he wants to do is put on a great show for you fans here at Monster Jam. This is the best stadium that we can set the stage at for the World Finals, and Bryce is somebody that wants to always put on a great show.
And his crew chief, Matt Del Sanger, definitely I know is probably heartbroken back there as well. He has worked back at the shop there on that Monster Jam truck. We have your current freestyle leader, Todd LeDuc in Megalodon. Todd, I know that you're known for going big. You've coined the LeDuc Leap, but I'm calling that one the LeDuc Loop. You were coming at that ramp with some speed. It looked like you premeditated that.
Yeah, I was. You know, I was trying to play it safe, but this freestyle course, I'm telling all the other contestants that are about to go, it is a fun track. It doesn't look very fun, but as a driver, you can do a really fast-paced run, you can fly through the air, you can do a lot of tricks. So I think it's going to be a really, really good track. And I was actually, to be honest with you, I was trying to do a double backflip. It's World Finals 22. Why not go for a 20, you know, a double backflip? So, unbelievable. Thank you, fans, for giving me a great score. There's no weird, like, it's the craziest feeling ever being, I don't know, 40 feet in the air upside down. So, I hope you guys enjoyed it. It's World Finals. I go bigger than ever.
That track a little bit, because you're such a technical driver that it's kind of that mix between spontaneity and planning out your run. So what were your thoughts trying to find that flow out there in freestyle?
Just, you gotta feel your time. These fans wanna see, even the fan judges, they wanna see a full run. You gotta get to the end. You gotta be careful with these sponsor trucks. They are very tough, and our technicians are the best, but you still gotta be nice to them. So the track is very fun, very cool. It's easy to spot where you wanna land. So I wanna see if anybody else can tell my run. If not, I'll take that championship.
Todd, congratulations, thank you so much. A lot more freestyle action coming your way. Courtesy of Todd, you can hang on to the lead.
Coming up next! Thank you.
hitting the step up. He had a lot of big air, a ton of momentum. When you get stopped with 13 seconds in the run, that last 10, 15 seconds is a Hail Mary. You want to just send the truck as far as you can, especially with a run like that. Great backflip, great momentum, everything that you want to see in a great run.
Morgan, is there anything you can do with just 13 seconds that's a little different from what Armando Castro went for?
Yeah, I wouldn't have went for a stoppie or a moonwalk or anything. I think I would have turned and just moonshot that thing, because I think the fans are waiting for the wow moment, and that's what you want to do. Turn, downshift first, second gear, and send it to the moon.
You okay?
I think that's the perfect definition right there of where he's going to come up a little bit short in fourth place. The fans at 7.639 are expert judges, a bit lower than that, and that's going to equal a 6.945 in fourth place for El Toro Loco.
Well, I think one thing that's happened tonight so far is our expert judges, spot on. Fans, spot on. Almost. Just keep doing those judgeszone.com. Make sure that you have the Monster Jam app downloaded as well. Monster Jam World Finals app is very easy.
water, some axle issues, so more, you know, you had already saw that here just a little bit ago. You were telling me about that. Look at that back rear axle, okay, Young, and that's where we see maybe why she couldn't land that backflip.
Yeah, a couple of jumps in, it's just a little hard on the throttle. I think that when you break an axle in the rear, the front is okay because you can drive with it open like that. But when it's in the rear, it takes all the momentum, all the traction out of the truck. And that's why you started to see the truck, as she would take off the ramps, it started to rotate a bit in the air. You take a look at the replay board here. About halfway through the run, she starts to descend a little bit sideways. I think maybe this run right here.
Well, a couple more seconds are on the video board there for Kayla Budd and Soldier Fortune. Scores are in.
There you can see right on cue, 7th place for Kayla Budd and Soldier Fortune. Really making something out of nothing with that run down to the break.
We've got our 2019 Freestyle World Champion, Lindsay Reed, Scooby-Doo. Lindsay, it's been so cool to not only watch all the action out there on the track, but to watch the driver reactions as well. And I know that you're going a little bit later in the driver lineup. I want to know how you're feeling right now. I know it's great to watch how the trucks react out there, but does it create a little bit of anticipation, a little bit of nerves?
Absolutely. I've been telling everybody that in 2019 I went out second, so I really didn't have time to think about anything. I just went out there, wanted to put on a solid run for all my Scooby-Doo fans and all you Monster Jam fans out there, and it worked out great for me. Watching is making me a little nervous, but it's also showing me all of these hits and what's reacting and what's doing what. So maybe it'll help me out even more, and I'll go out there and I'll lay down a solid freestyle for all you guys. I'm super proud of Kayla Budd out there. I know she was broken, but you know what? She wanted to give it her all for all you Storms and Fortune fans. Kristen Anderson out there, put on a solid run. All the girls are doing amazing. So now I need to go out there and step up my game and be on top of them.
Very well said. Well, Lindsay, thank you so much. Good luck. We're excited to see you out there on the track.
Take a look off of the big board for the Target Freestyle leaderboard thus far. We got Meg Ledonne and Todd LeDoux in the number one spot. He's followed by Monster Light and Bruce Kohler. And rounding out with top three, Cody Zosia and Dragon. Some familiar names with a not so familiar name sandwich there in the number two spot. Plenty of more action coming your way here in Monster Jam Freestyle. Coming up next,
Jordan Company!
looks like he has been shook off by the Monster Jam officials. That light that we've been talking about all night was flashing in the windshield. Not sure exactly what is exactly happening over there.
He has climbed down that Monster Jam track. Tonight's salute from John Gordon. That means the run is over and that means scoring is open.
Yes, definitely. Scoring is open, of course. Remember, when you see that original Super Blue Boot to the action replay, not only from John Gordon and Bad Company, but the rest of our field of competition, remember, it is a highlight package reel of all the best tricks, the best moves there from our drivers that will help you get those scores locked in fairly there at judgeszone.com. We are waiting your scores. We got about a couple seconds left. Remember, 30 seconds on the clock. Once those blue boards go red here for each and every one of our competitors.
With John Gordon, Bad Company, great run, a lot of momentum. Take a look at the replay board here. John is somebody that always carries a ton of momentum. Great throttle rhythm, but in all safety, the Monster Jam officials did the right thing.
And there you see the score up on the video board. He'll take over seventh place with a 5.847, and that will not be enough. And top spot will continue to belong to Tom the Duke and
Nathan. Kinda, it'll be lit up by then.
Coming up next, two-time Freestyle World Finals champion, Jim Kohler, Avenger!
Dude, are you in first grade?
Okay, it looks like we have a few members of our tech officials and track construction recovery team out there picking up the pieces, and now's the perfect time to give a shout out to all of them. I know we talked a lot about the dirt crew earlier today, but